Bam, it's true. We're going to continue our discussion about geometric sequences by talking about the nth partial sum. How do you add up n number of terms in a geometric sequence? Well, the formula is equal to S of n, and n, again, denoting where you are in the sequence. If n is equal to 10, you're at the 10th number. And we're going to find the sum of the first 10. That's equal to a sub 1 times 1 minus r to the n over 1 minus r. Our first example is a very, very straightforward question. We have the values of 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, and 32. This is clearly a geometric sequence because all we're doing is multiplying by 2. So we have an r value equal to 2 and an a sub 1 value, well, equal to 1. So to find the partial sum of these first 6 terms, which clearly we can just do in our head, but, you know, for teaching purposes, we like to start with the small numbers, plus I'm trying to do this mental math as much as possible in front of the camera. But anyway, we'll just check our work. 32, 42, 48, 56, 60, 62, and 63. So when we apply this formula, we should be getting a sum of 63 if we do it correctly. So S sub 6, because we're going to find the sum of these first 6 terms, is equal to A sub 1, which is 1, times 1 minus r, and we have a constant ratio of 2, raised to the n power, and we want to find the sum of the first 6 terms, so n is equal to 6, over 1 minus r, which again is 2. We'll have this issue with the second one. Make sure that if your r value is negative, you do not cancel it with the minus that's in the equation. You have to apply exponents before you multiply. When you have two negatives side by side, and you cancel those and make it a plus sign, you are doing multiplication. So don't mess up the order of operations. We have 1 times, this is going to be 1 minus 2 to the 6, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, and 64, over 1 minus 2, which is negative 1. This comes out to be negative 63, because 1 minus 64 is, well, negative 63, over negative 1, and we do know that when we divide two negatives, we get a positive answer. So indeed, we do, at least at this very simple example, check out that the partial sum formula does actually work. We have another example here. It's a little bit more complicated because of the r value being a fraction, but we're only going to find the sum of the first 4 terms. So, again, you might still want to just do this, you know, mentally in your head, but when we start adding up a lot more than just a few terms, you definitely want to apply this shortcut formula. So S sub 4, because we're going to find the sum of the first 4, is equal to A sub 1, which is 27, times 1 minus R. Notice I'm using the parentheses when I plug in my R value. That usually helps students make fewer sign errors. So it's 20 A sub 1 times 1 minus R to the n power. We're just going to find the sum of the first 4 over 1 minus r, which again is negative 1/3. So you can see I'm going to have a respectable amount of fraction work here to do and help you review it as well. So we're going to have 27 over 1 minus. Again, I'm not going to cancel out those negatives because I have to do my exponent first. So we have 1 to the 4th, which of course is 1. And then 3 to the 4th. Well, that's 3, 9, 27, and then 27 times 3 is going to be 81 over 1 minus, excuse me, 1 plus 1/3. Now here I can do negative times negative as positive because I'm not applying some kind of exponent that I have to do first. And note, if you had canceled these out, you would have a sign error. We need a common denominator, so we're going to turn the 1 into 81 over 81. And we get 27 times 81 minus 1 is 80 over our common denominator of 81. And that's all over, again, we need common denominators, so we're going to change that to 3 over 3 and get 4/3. I think we're going to have some cancellation here, so let's go ahead and, well, let's see if we can cancel like right now. 27 and 81. How many 27s are in 81? 81 has a factor of 9 in it. 27 has a factor of 9 in it. 81 might not be so obvious, but it has a factor of 3, and so does 27. So basically, 81 divided by 27 reduces down to be 1/3. So now we're going to take that 80 over 3. We're also going to flip up the denominator, because when you divide fractions, this is 80 now over 3 divided by 4 over 3, and you multiply by the reciprocal of the second fraction, and the denominator will be that second fraction. We get 80 over 3 times 3 over 4. Now, obviously, the 3s are going to cancel out, leaving us values of 1, and the 4 is going to cancel out. 80 divided by 4 is equal to 20, and our partial sum comes out to be equal to 20. So, that is the end of my second example. I'd like to do one more example like this, but one that has some summation notation. I'll be right back. So here's our last example. Another one that's going to have a respectable amount of fraction work in it, just to make sure that you get that review you need. And this time, though, our geometric expression is written in summation notation. So I want to find the sum of the first four terms of this geometric sequence. And how do I know that it's 4? Because I'm starting to count at 1, and I'm going to 4. This were 2 and 4. 4 minus 2 is equal to 2, but I have to add 1, so it would be 3, because we start counting as soon as we see the first term, and then second, third, and fourth. If we had a value of 2 here, it'd be 2, 3, 4. So you subtract and then add 1. And you don't have to really do any kind of fancy math like that for just, you know, lower index of 1 and 4. But if this were a very large number, like maybe 28, and the lower index was 4, 28 minus 4 is 24. And then add 1 and you'd be finding the sum of the first 25 terms. Okay. Well, the formula for a partial sum of a geometric sequence is S sub n equals a sub 1 times 1 minus r to the n over 1 minus r. And how do I know that this is geometric? Because I have an initial amount, and I'm constantly multiplying repetitively by the value of 3 halves, and I know I'm doing constant multiplication because I have this variable in the exponent showing me that's the repetition that I'm doing. Exponents show repetitive multiplication, and that's what the geometric setting is, again. So, we need a sub 1. So, we're going to let I equal 1. Let's put it here. For I equals 1, we're going to have 8 times 3 over 2 to the I plus 1, or 1 plus 1 power. That's going to be 8. That's 2. So, 3 squared is 9. Over 2 squared, which is 4, and 8 divided by 4 is equal to 2. So 2 times 9 is equal to 18. So the first term of my geometric sequence is equal to 18. So my partial sum, the sum of my first four terms, again going from the lower index of 1 to 4, means I'll have four terms in the sequence. S sub 4 is equal to A sub 1, which is 18, times 1 minus my constant ratio of R. This is what has the this is the base with the exponent, the variable exponent. So my R value is 3 halves to the n power over 1 minus R, which is again 3 halves. Okay, so this is going to come out to be 18 times 1 minus 3 to the 4th. Again, 3, 9, 27, 81 over 2 to the 4th, which is 2, 4, 8, 16 over 1 minus 3 halves. If you want to write that as a common denominator now, that's 2 over 2, and 2 minus 3 is negative 1 over 2. Don't add the denominators, nor do you subtract them. And just make sure I don't make any mistakes here. Good. Now we're going to do 1 minus 81 over 16. So just to make sure I don't run out of space, let's write this 1 with a common denominator of 16 and make it 16 over 16. And that's going to give us 18. 16 minus 81. Now, in my head, I would do 81 minus 10 is 71, and 71 minus 6 is 65, so it should be negative 65 over 16 over again, negative 1 half. And again, just to make sure I'm not making any mistakes here. Good. Now, let's see. Let's go ahead and we'll keep all this written in multiplication form, and we're going to flip up that denominator because we're dividing by a fraction, so I want to show the multiplication of the reciprocal. We'll have a little interruption there. So again, we're going to take the denominator and flip it up. So we're going to have 18 over 1. We're going to have negative 65 over 16. And again, we're going to take that denominator and flip it up and have negative 2 over 1. Let's reduce this and multiply it, and we'll be done. Two negatives will multiply together to make a positive answer. 2 and 16. Now, 2 and 16 will cancel out to be 1 and 8. And then we can cancel some more because 8 is even and so is 18. So we're going to divide both of these by 2. 8 divided by 2 is equal to 4. And 18 divided by 2 is equal to 9. So we have, basically we have 1 times 9 and then 9 times 65. Well, 9 times 60 is 540. 9 times 5 is 45. So 540 and 45 is equal to 585 over a denominator of 1 times 1 times 4, which is our final answer of 585 over 4. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.